John Lennon and Paul McCartney. For more than 50 years, they are widely considered the greatest songwriting team in music history. But hold on, look again more closely. Lennon, McCartney, and Finkelstein? That's right. In an explosive new autobiography, Rabbi Murray Finkelstein makes the jaw-dropping claim that he helped co-write many of the Fab Four's biggest hits. Reluctant to come forward for over 50 years, until now, Finkelstein spoke exclusively to our own Ben Michaels early this morning. Okay. How are you, Rabbi? Nice to meet you.
Shalom.
Shalom. Do you want to do this here, or would you rather go inside?
Let's go in.
Inside?
Let's go in.
Okay. Come on, guys. We're heading in.
Sit down.
Oi.
Here, for your head. Put it on.
Rabbi, you claim in 1963, Brian Epstein approached you in shul one day and asked for a favor.
That's right. Brian was bar mitzvahed my synagogue. He was a fegeler, but a good boy chick. I knew his mishpacha, his family, for years. So he shows up in shul on Yom Kippur and says he needs my help. Could you write me some new songs, he says. New? Go figure. He didn't say why, but he needed them right away. I said, Brian, I write Yiddish songs, not that fakakta rock and roll the kids liked. But he wouldn't leave. What a kvetch, a nudge, a nudnik. So I sit down and write 50 songs in one weekend.
And you gave those to Brian?
Every one, that bastard.
May I have a look?
Here.
So these are all your original songs, Rabbi, correct? Hey Jew, I'm happy just to fast with you. She loves Jews. This goy. Oy bladi, oy blada. Got to get Jews into my life. Schwitz and shout. You better lose that goy. Wow, these song titles and lyrics sure seem very similar to Beatles songs. Here's a prime example. I don't want to spoil the Seder. I don't want to spoil the Seder, so I'll go. I would hate my wine-stained talus to show. There's nothing for me here. They just ran out of beer. If she turns about my shul, please let me know. It sure sounds like the Beatles ripped you off, Rabbi. Were you compensated at all for your work?
Garnished! Bupkes! That bastard Brian Epstein? He should drop that again!
Rabbi, let's briefly go back to 1964. In your book, you say you gave these songs to Brian Epstein, didn't think anything of it until 6 weeks later, when you suddenly started hearing your songs on the radio. What was your reaction?
I got a little verblunged. I was upset.
Upset? Rabbi Finkelstein, let's not sugarcoat this. You were infuriated. In fact, you were so angry that you tried interrupting a local TV interview the boys were giving so you could spill the beans, so to speak. Let's watch.
Oy vey. I know that those two guys are lying bastards, but how can you two keep up these fashtunken lies? How did this happen?
It just happened, and so we don't have to keep it up. We just remain ourselves. Don't we, Ringo?
Well, we do. I mean,
you're next. I'm coming. Remember me, Mr. Lennon and McCartney? Here are all the songs I wrote. Where are the songs you two wrote? Nebach. Why did you change the title of your new movie from the one I wrote, It's Been a Meshuggah Shabbos, to a different one?
Well, it's a logical step, isn't it? And I believe it's quite lucrative, I believe.
Anyway, someone asked us.
Yeah, we were asked to do it. We said, yeah. And Alan Owen wrote it.
Bullshit.
And we changed it, and we're all...
A Meshuggah Shabbos.
Hard day's night.
Your local cinema now.
You know nothing. Nothing. So here's your chance. Tell everyone, who writes your songs?
Guitars and things. You know, normally we sit down and try and bash one out or something. But then again, there's no formula, because he can come up with one day completely finished. We still say we both wrote it.
Zangezunt. I'll see you in court. You should all be ashamed of yourselves. Big shots, this interview is over. Get up. Everyone get up. Geh weg. Go home. Crooks, schnorrers.
Sadly, you never did reconcile with Brian Epstein prior to his death. But shortly thereafter, the Beatles did reach out to you and wanted to make things right. What happened?
Right before they broke up, they flew into town, made a special trip to see me. Said they owed me something. So they left a small box next to the Torah, shook my hand, and left.
And just how much money was in that box, Rabbi?
Money? I wish. It was matzah, those cheap bastards. Want a piece?
Rabbi Finkelstein, thank you so much for allowing us to visit with you today and for sharing your incredible story with our viewers.
You're welcome.
As a final favor to us and just for old time's sake, would you honor us by playing us out with one of your early hits?
Oh, Love Me Jew, my first number one hit. I'd love to. Boy, I'm a little rusty. Excuse me.
Love me, dude.